नमस्कार। टुडे वी विल सी द सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ गॉसेस लॉ। वंस अगेन विल टेक एन एग्जाम्पल विच इज सिमेट्रिक इन नेचर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट।
सो नाउ विल सी इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू अ यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड इनफाइनाइट प्लेन शीट। So let us consider infinite plane sheet. We use the symbol sigma to be the uniform surface charge density of that infinite plane sheet. If we keep the plane vertical, I mean this way, and say this is the x direction, so x axis. So if we say x axis is this, and we have kept the plane like this, and x axis is normal to the plane of plane which we have considered, then the electric field will not depend on y and z coordinates, and its direction at every point will be parallel to x-axis. Okay, so electric field direction will be parallel to the x-axis. So let us see, take this plane sheet and let us consider it to be positively charged, right? So if that is a thing, let us construct a Gaussian surface. Let us, since we have taken a rectangular plane sheet, we'll construct a rectangular parallelopiped Gaussian surface of cross-sectional area A. We're constructing a Gaussian surface which has cross-sectional area A. So this area is A. This face, cross-sectional area is A. This is A, right? And of course, on the other side, means it's through and through. We have to consider the Gaussian surface, right? Enclosed. Now, this surface to be at a distance x from the plane. Same way on this direction. This is plus x direction. This direction is minus x direction. Let us consider that because we have taken in the direction of the coordinate axis for convenience. So this is, so electric field on at this face will be in this direction, right? And electric field here will be in minus x direction. So the flux, say now here, before talking about the flux, here the electric field is in this direction, which is parallel to the planes. All the planes here, all the other faces, 1, 2, 3 and 4, similarly 1, 2, this side, the below, the other side and the top, they all are parallel, means electric field is parallel to the surfaces. That means area vectors here will be normal to the electric field. Angle between area vector and the field will be 90 degrees. Hence, cos 90 is 0. So, these faces do not contribute to the flux. Which areas contribute? Because here E and area vector are parallel, that means angle between them is 0. Hence, this surface, so I can say surface 1 and surface 2 contribute to the flux, and the other surfaces do not contribute to the flux. So, flux through each surface, what I'm talking is each surface, means this is surface 1 and surface 2. Now, flux, this direction of E here is plus x direction, here it is minus x direction. So, the total flux will add up, flux through this surface and flux through this surface will add up. Okay, so what will be the flux through each surface? So, both these faces contribute to the flux. So, flux through each surface is given by, you know, it is E dot delta S, right? Which will be equal to, since E and delta S, the angle between them is 0, the magnitude will be, means flux is a scalar. So what will be the final answer? E into delta S into cos theta, but theta is 0, so cos 0 is 1. So hence E dot delta S will be equal to EA. So here now, through each surface is EA, so both will add up together, and hence we get total flux through both these surfaces through, we can say now, through the Gaussian surface is therefore 2EA, 2 times EA. Now let us consider the Gauss's law. Using Gauss's law, what will be the flux through the thing? It is total charge enclosed divided by epsilon 0. What is the total charge enclosed? We have to look at the surface charge density multiplied by the area. So let us see, this is the, so we have this, you can see this, you can see this. This is a plane, right? This sheet has area A and surface charge density sigma. So sigma into A will be the total charge here. So that is enclosed through the, inside that enclosed surface. So Gaussian surface. So here, what we go through is, using Gauss's law, total flux will be Q upon epsilon 0. So, since charge enclosed is sigma A, we can say total flux will be equal to sigma A upon epsilon 0. Total flux will be equal to sigma A upon epsilon 0. So, therefore, now, total flux is 2EA and we can also write it as sigma A upon epsilon 0. So, these right-hand sides can be equated. So, what we have? 2EA is will be equal to sigma A upon epsilon 0. Hence, E will be equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon 0. Right? If I want to write it in a vector form, it will be vector E will be equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon 0 into unit vector n, which is in the direction perpendicular to the plane of the sheet. Now here one more thing comes, we understand that E is independent of the distance of the point where we want to find the electric field. So it does not depend where we are taking the electric field from the sheet. All is every point it is constant. Of course, we have to understand that it shouldn't be towards the edge. In finite plane we are considering, so all over central of the plane, very large plane, so central portion of the plane, all points it will be constant. It does not depend on where the point is. We have to also understand, we had in the beginning we took positive charges, suppose, then the direction of the field will be away from perpendicular, in the perpendicular direction to the plane of the sheet, and also going away from the sheet. If the charges are negative, then the field will be towards the plane, towards the sheet. Okay, so this is what we have understood. So this is the formula for electric field. So we have used a Gauss's law to find the electric field near a uniformly charged plane in finite sheet.
Okay then, the third and the last example we will see in the next session. That's all for today. See you next time.